Hi everyone, I created this video to help you learn how to send a fax from your Gmail account. It's really easy, it's not expensive, and you don't have to worry about any complicated installations. I'm at a site right now that I found called gmailfaxguide.com. It helped me learn a little bit more about how to get started, and basically I started with the RingCentral fax service. They have a 30-day free trial, and I'm going to walk you through the whole entire process. So first I click on that link right there. And it takes me to this sign up page, 30-day free trial, $7.99 a month. After that you get 500 free fax pages, all these little details here as well. It works great. I haven't had any problems with it. Best of all, I can fax from my email, even from my iPhone, since I can access my email through there. Whatever phone you have, you can fax through there as well. So it's really easy. So just click on sign up. And you get a lot of options as far as what kind of plan you want. It all depends on how much faxing you do each month. I go with a basic plan. You know, that's good for me. So go here to free trial. And you get to pick a toll-free number, a vanity number, or a local number. Whatever works best for you. Let's go with a toll-free number. So I'm going to choose here the 855. You can choose from any of these numbers, whichever you like. And continue, and then you fill out your general information. So give me a second here to fill this all out. And just in case, here at the bottom it lets you know again, when your trial period ends, in this case on 06/30/2013, you'll be charged if I don't cancel by that date. So once again, they're letting you know. Okay, so once you sign up, they give you your fax number. It's free. It's a completely free fax number. You don't have to set anything up. It's set already in just a few minutes. So this is my fax number. Okay, I still need to activate my account. Has been sent to my email. And I just have to confirm that. And then there's an explanation here that says how to send faxes. Okay, to receive faxes, basically shows you the process. Customer sends you a fax. Goes to RingCentral. You can receive it in your email as a PDF attachment. You can receive it on your mobile phone, and you can also have messages tab in your online account, your online dashboard. Okay, to send faxes is easy as well. This is what you gotta listen to right here. Here's how you send a fax. Just open a new email in the to field, put the fax number just like it's showing here, followed by @rcfax.com. So say we were going to send a fax to that number, I'd go to create a new mail, put in the fax number followed by RCFax, the subject, and then, you know, any message I need to put in here. I can attach any file I need. File gets sent to RingCentral, and your receiver receives the fax. It's that easy. If you can access your email through, you know, your phone, you can do that from there as well. Or you can use the RingCentral iPhone app. You have all these tools available to you. Works for iPhone, Android, BlackBerry, on PC or Mac. Okay, so to receive faxes to your Gmail account with RingCentral, just go under Settings, and under Notifications, you can see here Receive Faxes. Here's Notification Options, and here you go, Send Notifications To. Put in the email you want, your phone number. You know, if you want to do a text message, so it goes to your phone. You can get fax transmission results sent to you as well. So you've got a lot of options. It's really easy. Just under Settings, Notifications, add the email, and automatically all of your received faxes will be sent to your email. I'm using RingCentral, but there are other options such as MyFax and ExtivaFax, which work really well too. It all depends, you know, on your preference. So check that out. And happy faxing.